Afraid to try a remote collar for punishment without conditioning my dog to the collar first. Heard y'all say bullshit. You can use it as a punisher. Got a different dog now. Thanks.
Yep, you sure can. But more lies. More lies are being spread. Next.
Imagine that if you had to teach every command before you could punish for like counter-serving.
Yeah.
It's like, wait 6 weeks, buddy.
We talked about that at this weekend seminar.
I know.
Dog trainers are lying.
It's crazy.
That's why so many dog trainers hate me, because I'm telling the truth and they're like, I'm ruining it. I'm the one that's going to ruin shock collars. So I'm like, no, it's not. All you guys arguing with each other, that's what's ruining the dog training.
Mm-hmm.
That they don't get it.
No.
We're live. Let me get the camera a little bit this way. Oh, this way. So Joe's in the shot. Hey, everybody.
Okay, I don't need to be here.
Hello. Yeah, you do. Trust me, I can't do this show without you. Hey, everybody. How are you? It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training live from Fargo, North Dakota.
Oh, yeah. The lighting looks better on my phone.
Okay, cool. We just finished up.
It's good lighting.
What's today?
I approve.
Day two? No, it's Monday. Yesterday was day two. Day two of a great seminar. Fargo, North Dakota. Joelle has been battling sickness, but putting up posts all day long. So there's been some really great videos going up, some really good emotional stuff going up. We've got a lot of photos going up. We just announced New Zealand last night at midnight. It dropped, as they say in the industry. Tickets are already selling extremely well. We did a lot of work today. We did about a 5-hour business consult today. Joelle worked with a private client one-on-one, which was really, really fantastic. Kudos to you for doing that. And so we can multitask, mm-hmm. You know, we can help as many people as possible. This is a Q&A show, and most people are going to be asking me how to fix problems. My seminar series, which by the way, has got three, we're doing a New Zealand, Brisbane, Australia, Singapore tour. So up to three international cities. And then in the US in 2020, we're going to be doing probably about 25 cities in North America, which will be Canada and the United States, primarily in the United States where we're based. This weekend we'll be in Charlotte, North Carolina, and we're up to about 50 people right now. So there's audit tickets still available, and it's hot down there. It's in the 90s, so we're improvising with some cooling solutions. So this was gonna be like under this big tent, which it still is, but it's like now it's gonna be a little bit warm. So fans and portable air conditioners that are used for like weddings and events and stuff like that. We're getting pretty creative. So tomorrow we leave here at 4 o'clock in the morning, 4:15 in the morning. We leave here, jump on a plane, arrive in Providence at about noon, 12:15, and then possibly leaving tomorrow night. We're still negotiating that. Code word for arguing, about should we leave tomorrow night or do we wait until 6 a.m. Wednesday, which would give us, what would give Joelle one night
of sleep
in my own bed. Sleeping in your own bed. So we've got to figure that one out. But then it's like, just me driving 2 long days. So we'll see what happens. Anyway, the seminars are also problem solving as well. And that's, again, people bring me their dogs to, how do I stop unwanted behaviors? How do I stop unwanted behaviors? Now, we make some great progress in 2 days.
Mm-hmm.
Incredible progress in 2 days. So if you've got the dog that's out there that's like, I can't bring my dog. Yes, you can. We have no restrictions on dogs. Human aggression, dog aggression, leash reactivity, separation anxiety, won't go in a crate. Like, if you can get the dog in the building, we'll work with your dog. And nobody's getting bit. Everybody's safe. Everything will be fine. So, and we've got, 150 seminars to prove it. And we've got, lots of, so it's 1,000 people a year. So definitely want to check those out. You can go to jeffgelmanseminars.com. So that, and then this podcast is mostly problem solving. Obviously, our board and train center, which is based in Providence, Rhode Island, FYI, we're hiring. We're looking for a trainer, an experienced trainer. Experienced trainer for the Providence seminar. location. It's my only location. We might need some part-time kennel staff, but the big thing right now is we definitely need a dog trainer. And ask your questions. Most of my answers are going to be punishment-based. Why? Because you can't stop an unwanted behavior with a reward. And for all the people out there that are living this fantasy world that all you have to do is reward your dog and do things that are gentle and kind and loving and force-free, unfortunately, you're not in the same arena as I am. And you don't know the dogs that I know. And you're also possibly lying. There's a lot of people out there that will preach force-free and positive, but meanwhile with their own dogs, they're using tools, or even with their client dogs, they're using tools. So what it is just a bunch of hypocrisy and lies and unethical behavior, because they don't want the pushback, they don't want the hate, they want to be part of the nice dog trainer club. They're afraid of all the pushback. Ironically, they're the ones that are doing the most yelling and screaming, and all they have to do is stop. You know? So be nice. Be nice. So there's a little dollar sign at the bottom of your screen, which is for Top Chat. And what that does is that's a YouTube created thing, and that you can throw a little bit of cash our way because you appreciate all the years of free content. Or in this instance, your question goes to the top of the queue. It gets read first, but you do not have to pay to play. We will answer every question that we can fit in the time slot. Most questions get answered very short, where most questions need a very long answer. We also offer Skype and many other alternatives to get your questions answered. So, Joelle, read the question.
Blessing. Hey, J&J, my dog is doing great, and we are working on finding a friend with a chill dog. However, my dog is starting to develop separation anxiety. My family tells me he whines when I leave, and I crate him at night and when I leave the house, and I don't greet him until he calms down. I'm even limiting affection because he's still working on things. How do I fix this?
You have to ask your family to use the remote collar to stop the whining. Leave a remote collar on your dog. Train your family how to use a remote collar and to stop it. And that's how you do it. So that's how whining stops, through an applied punisher. Remember, whenever I talk about punishment, guys, there's no yelling, there's no screaming, you're not mad, you're not angry, you're not upset. It's just a matter of fact. Don't do that. Next.
Alicia, so my wife is constantly giving too much affection, feeding treats and people food to the dog straight from her hand. Mm-hmm. What is your opinion on her ruining the relationship between the dogs and myself? When we come home, the dogs run straight to her. They're always ignoring my instruction. They only look to her even though I'm the only one giving them guidance. And yes, my wife was the one that was hitting them out of frustration, in case y'all forgot. She has such a polar opposite relationship with them. She gives way too much affection and then gets mad when they end up rowdy. Right. Like, duh, dude, you just got them all worked up. What did you think would happen?
Right. So, to me, if we humanize that, which I will play the human game all day long, that is the human form of an abusive relationship. So, sounds like couples counseling is in order. And I'm 100% serious. This is not a dog issue. This is a relationship issue. And you two need to straighten out your relationship before any dog training advice is given. Obviously, she's fucking up the dogs. But the real question is, why? That's where human counseling, relationship counseling, comes into play. But your relationship with your partner is not functioning well, and the dogs are paying the ultimate price. So I would either suggest splitting or getting into counseling, but those are the only two options right now. Or, well, getting rid of the dogs, right? So, but that's probably not an option. So you separate the relationship or you get into counseling. Next.
Enlightened canine perspective, teaching 10-week-old puppy out, pet convincer.
Okay, if it works, that's great. Next.
Britt, walks are so peaceful and happy, my shepherd is a changed dog.
Well, I didn't hear that.
You didn't
hear it? I heard the changed dog. What did you say at first?
Am I talking too quiet?
No.
Did you just like tune me out?
No, I don't tune you out because I'll get hit.
Britt, walks are so peaceful and happy. My shepherd is a changed dog.
Oh, awesome. Congratulations.
Michelle, good evening. Jeff and Joelle, photos from Fargo were awesome. Glad you had a great trip.
Awesome. Well, we haven't put them up yet.
Maybe just like random ones.
Oh, I've got. How many did you put? How many did you have? 300?
Close to it.
Yeah, the photo album's going up tonight, as long as the Wi-Fi will have the upload speed to do it. Next.
Melissa, good evening, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, Melissa. Hey, Melissa, how are you?
Teresa, good evening, Joelle and Jeff.
Hey, guys. Hello. Next.
Travis, went to a local therapy dog club orientation testing Saturday.
Yep.
Was immediately told the group doesn't allow these kinds of collars.
Correct.
Calling and remote. Agreed. Said thank you and walked out like yep. George.
But they're all going to say that. They're all going to say that. So what you can do is follow their rules to get your therapy certification and then go on your own journey. Next.
Blessing. Wow, Joelle, you're looking pretty cute today. Thanks, Blessing.
So frankly, she looks cute every day. But she'll take the compliment. And I agree 100%. Next.
Shafali, the shock doesn't faze my pit. What do I do?
The what?
Shock. Are you hard of hearing today?
The shock? Yeah. I don't know what. Okay, I don't know. Number one, I would go with collar fit. Is it fit right? Super snug. Both prongs up against the dog's neck. What's the brand? Is it turned on? And I'm being serious. Is this part turned on? Is this part turned on? What's the brand? What level are you on? But fit is number one. Next.
Teresa, we are enjoying our off-leash walk in the park as we listen.
Awesome. Congratulations. Still pay attention to your dog. Next.
Britt, 7 months ago, I would have had 15 questions. Now I have none and a relaxed shepherd.
Wow. 15 to none. Sounds like I was going to do a sports analogy, but I don't know any. I guess that sounds like a...
The old goose egg.
Is that what, there you go. You know more about sports than I do.
Not
yes.
really.
Yeah, you do.
Alicia, she feeds the snacks, treats, and food all without them earning it.
This is the dysfunctional relationship.
Yes.
Yeah, I know. Marriage counseling. Next.
Been there, got the t-shirt to prove it.
Yep. You.
Kyle. Maybe you too.
You guys never went to counseling. You went right to the divorce.
No, but it was dysfunctional.
Yeah, but yeah, you just went right to the divorce.
And it was always the dog that was like...
Yep. Ooh. And you just went right to the divorce.
Yeah. Why would I stick around?
You're like one year sober.
Hi, guys. After having my GSD do a complete U-turn the other day, I reduced affection to next to none, been very abrupt with the commands with correction, and bonker for crate whining seems to be working.
Awesome job, Kyle.
Good job, Kyle.
Proud of you.
Bitless equestrian. Hey, guys. Any tips for an escape artist? My dog goes out in the morning, and it's starting to worry me that maybe he'll get out again and get hit. Oh, he got out this morning.
Yeah, so where did he get out? Where's the weak point of the yard? Secure that. You can do perimeter underground fencing, hot wire, like that. Keep your dog on a leash when you go outside. But find out how the dog got out and secure that next.
Deborah, how can I stop my 11-month-old from jumping on me or my visitor?
That is easier than teaching a sit. Go to my YouTube channel, watch. In my YouTube channel, search how to stop jumping. I stop jumping in less than 3 seconds. Next.
Deborah, I just read that. Cheyenne, we were finally able to have Zeke off leash in the park. He ignored squirrels, muzzled in case another dog comes around. We got our first compliment on his muzzle. A person thanked me for being safe.
See that? Yes. Anytime you see a dog in a muzzle, give him at least a minimum of a thumbs up. Next. Plus, it takes a brave person to put a muzzle on their dog in 2019, at least in the United States. Next.
Deborah, I have to protect him from jumping on me. I don't know what that means.
I don't know what that means. No, your dog should never want to, you should never allow your dog to jump on you. Next.
Kyle, however, today he was on the 30-foot long line on a field when a spaniel ran up on him from behind. It was off leash. He did not see it until it was basically on him. He was right beside me and reacted aggressively.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So that's the downfall of dogs being in off leash areas, even though it was on a long line around other strange dogs. So theoretically, if your dog has that habit, it shouldn't have that much freedom right now until you straighten that out. Next.
Karen, GSD lover. Hey, Jeff and Joelle. Thanks for doing this. I always learn something.
You're welcome. It's a pleasure to do it. Thanks for consuming. Guys, you know, we thank you. You know, and also, if you're not one of our fans yet, join our channel, hit the notification bell. And then also, jump on Instagram, jump onto Facebook. Obviously, you're on YouTube. We update, I think today we put 3 to 4 updates on both channels. Also,
today, yeah.
if you guys can join angelogellman.com, angelogellman.com, sorry, at angelogellman.
Like he has a Thank website you. Now?
Yeah, he actually has a website. All my kids do.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, there's nothing on it. I own it. Parents, buy your kids' names right now.
Yeah.
Buy your kids' names. So all my kids, I have websites for them. There's nothing on them, but eventually there will be because I'm sure they're going to want them. But at Angelo Gellman on Instagram, join his channel. Next.
Edgar's, hello guys. When moving to new house, what would be the best way to introduce a dog to it? Many thanks.
Limited real estate. Next.
Tommy, hi J&J.
Hello.
Kaylee J, good evening, Jeff and Joelle. Just popping in to say hi. I have to watch the replay. It was fun getting messages from my cousin about your visit to their facility.
Hey, yeah, Jack's a great guy, and we met his wife. Ashley, I think his wife is. And we met the three kids. What'd you do with those baby pictures?
They're on stories.
Are they really?
They're videos, not photos.
Oh, really? Oh.
Oh, mm-hmm. Jeff quieting down a crying baby, but he made her cry to begin with. She didn't want to leave Mama, and you took her.
She handed her to me.
Yeah. But you could tell she didn't want to leave Mom.
Fine. And she had babies cry.
She was teething and...
And then who quieted her down in 30 seconds or less?
You did.
Okay. And then who had a great time with Uncle Jeff for an hour?
The baby did.
Okay. There you go. Don't roll your eyes at me.
I didn't.
Oh, you rolled your whole fucking face at me.
Cheyenne and Zeke. Glad to be back, though. We've been really busy. Grandpa's been in the hospital with cancer for the past month, but he's recovering
I'm
well.
Sorry to hear that. Good to hear.
Sorry, yeah.
Tell Grandpa, Jeff and Joelle, say, get better quick.
Yeah.
And you're still sexy as fuck, Grandpa. Next.
Mel, the bonk and prong collar saved my relationship with my Pomeranian thanks to your technique. Thanks.
You're welcome. Them little palms, man.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, little. Feisty little.
Yeah.
Feisty.
Got some great video footage of bonking a Pomeranian.
The one that wouldn't shut up.
The one that we can't show because it was so damn good. Next.
Tim, what style collar for leash control do you recommend for a puppy that's too young for a prong?
Pretty much nothing. I mean, how young is the puppy? Right now I'd be working on, we do all food clicker or food marker training. And we don't really focus too much on the walk up until 12 or 14 weeks old. And by then they're old enough to have a prong on. But you can just use a basic collar. Next.
Bitless Equestrian, do you have any tips for my Great Pyrenees stubbornness? I feel he isn't as stubborn as most, but he's still got it.
Yeah, motivation. What's the dog's motivator? Historically, compulsion works best. Mm. So that's leash pressure, leash pop, remote collar. Remote collar is a powerful motivator. Next.
I'm sorry, guys. Alicia, thank you so much. You guys are amazing. I totally understand.
Who's Alicia? The one with the dysfunctional marriage? Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
It goes that deep. A lot of people don't see that stuff.
Yeah, that's the answer. If anybody tries to give you dog training advice after you tell them that story, they don't know. They don't understand humans.
Yeah.
And they don't give a shit about you. They're too dog focused. They're not human focused. I'm human focused. This is the human business. Next.
Bronwyn, good evening, Jeff and Joelle. Wishing you both a wonderful week. Thanks, Bronwyn. That's so nice.
Bronwyn, thank you. I appreciate it.
Kyle, when I have the money, I'll be buying one of your Skypes for an extra bit of personalized advice. I've recently been made unemployed, so don't know when it will be, but I'll see you soon, Jeff.
So this is what I want you to do, Kyle. Right now in 2019, there's more money out there than there ever has been before. Okay? So what I want you to do is create a job. What do you want to do? What do you love to do, and can you monetize it? What's your hobby? Can you monetize it? Right now, there is so much opportunity to make money. Okay? Next.
You got like stray hair caught in your beard right now. Would it be weird if I pulled it out?
If you came, yeah. If you, that
okay.
Would
be, it's like driving me nuts.
Okay, then just tell me.
It's,
okay, if I go like this, is it gone?
Yeah.
Okay, great. And you didn't have to touch me. Cool.
Thank God.
Good.
Ryan. Hi, Jeff and Joelle. Happy Monday. Jeff, I want to email a private question. I tried Jeff Dog Gellman at Solid Canine Training. Is that right, or is it just Jeff at?
It's Jeff at. Why would you put Jeff Dog? It's Jeff at. It's easy to get a hold of
no,
me.
No, Jeff Dog Gellman, like Jeff period Gellman.
Right, so it's Jeff
at
Solid Canine Training. But also, if you ask me a question, I'm not going to answer it. I'm going to send you a copy and paste saying, go to these resources. You have to understand how many questions a day I get. And I give you I literally respond in a cut and paste response, which sounds like I don't care, but I care so much that I do three of these Q&As. What you do is you do a Skype. So if you need personalized help, you do a Skype. And if you're like, well, it's a quick answer. Everybody has a quick answer, wants a quick answer, and there is no quick answers. And it's no disrespect to you whatsoever. I would be overwhelmed. So I've got a very firm thing. It's like I have this platform. I do it 3 times a week. Next.
Kate, can my dogs wear their e-collars when they swim? I took them to the lake the other day because they love to swim. I didn't have them wear their e-collars because I didn't know. They acted like so misbehaved.
If it's Dogtra or e-collar technology, yes. I'm sure there's other. I'm sure Sport Dog also.
Make sure the little
charging port
is plugged in there, like,
right,
to stop the water, though.
Yes.
Novice mistake. Yes. Jamie. Hi, and thanks for your help. Wanted to say the hardest part about changing my dog is the part where I have to change.
Yes.
Any words of encouragement?
Change.
Just change.
Just change. So, yes, you have to change, just like anything else. So it's a discipline issue. So Joelle and I are on the road. We're in Fargo, North Dakota. We have a seminar, okay? We're exhausted. We're still fucking showing up. We went to the gym every day, okay? Well, Planet Fitness is closed on weekends. Well, they're open at 7, which is too late for us. What do? We joined Anytime Fitness for the weekend. We ate, we go to the supermarket, we ate healthy. We went out to eat once, and guess what? It's so hard to eat healthy at a restaurant. No, it's not. When you open up the menu, there's unhealthy food and healthy food. You tell the waiter or waitress what the option that is healthy is. So it's all discipline. So both of us, while we're away, we still eat healthy, we still work out, and we still don't get fucking any sleep. So we're consistent.
We're consistent.
Next.
I think I shut my eyes for like 30 minutes today. I think I fell asleep editing a video.
You did. You pulled a Jeff.
Yep.
You pulled a Jeff.
Jared, my dog will at times randomly go into a licking fit. He will lick all the floors and walls obsessively. Can this be behavioral?
Yeah, I would use a remote cower on that. Next. Any OCD behavior, remote cower, correct. Next.
Shefali, it is really on charge, and my other dog gets checked at 6 and 10. She jumps, but the pit went up to 35 and nothing.
Okay, so go up to 45, go up to 55, go up to 65, go up to 75. Also, what are you trying to get your dog to do? A lot of pitties will just sit there, and they'll take it. They'll take the correction, and they'll just go, and? So what do you want your dog to do? You have to still give it guidance. So food doesn't train a dog. You still have to train the dog. Food, you still have to train the actual dog. If I wanted my dog to roll over and I showed up and if I just said, here's food, roll over, it wouldn't roll over. If I wanted my dog to lie down and I just corrected it for not lying down, but it doesn't know down, you still have to train the dog. There is a process. Next.
You go. Thank you. After learning how to apply correction, I could take my crazy reactive dog to dock diving today. No reactivity and we all had fun.
That is incredible. Yuko, kudos to you. Fist bumps for Yuko.
Nicole, hey Jeff and Joelle, thank you so much for all the free content you provide. I was wondering if you prefer the e-collar or prong or both on walks.
Both, next. Prong for directional control, remote collar, because eventually I want to train that dog to be an off-leash trained dog. Next.
Maddie, started on the e-collar today and my dog listened, but her energy dropped down to mid-training went and hid in her crate. Is this normal or is it a sign of a level that's too high? To add to my last comment for context, my dog is usually extremely high energy and food motivated while training, and e-collar seemed to make her really reticent.
Right, resistant.
Resistant to take food and continue drills.
Right, you probably used it too high. You didn't probably layer properly. Probably had some handler error. You should be layering the remote over the existing training. Your level should be lower and the dog should still have its food drive. So there was handler error. So tomorrow, don't go so high and learn how to read the dog, okay? And also keep the kennel door closed. And also the dog should be on a leash. Next.
Bronwyn, haha, Uncle Jeff, the baby whisperer.
Damn fucking right. Yeah, sorry. It's a skill set I have.
Sorry, I'm good with babies. Kyle, thanks guys.
Was that you impersonating me?
There's a quiet field near where I live. I wasn't expecting any dogs to run up, but it must have ran a good 120 feet from its owner to approach my dog. He's never aggressive. I think he got a fright.
Probably. Next.
Edgar, sorry, I didn't understand your answer. Introducing dog to new home when moving. Thanks. You said give limited real estate.
Give limited real estate, meaning don't let your dog search the whole house. It's like your dog doesn't need to investigate. This is where you are. So now is a great time for you to exert your leadership. So your dog doesn't need to see every single room in the house, right? Because what they'll do is they'll end up marking in it. It's like, this is your room. You can use this room and this room. Next.
Travis, I have faith I could have took the collars off and rocked their chest, all from the What Would Jeff Do YouTube University.
Awesome. But this is the thing. For all your CGC stuff, for all your therapy dog, for all your that, for any of the testing, you have to follow the rules. So follow the rules. And then, good, the rules are done. And now you go back to your regular life. Next.
Kyle, I'd absolutely love to get into dog training, but with qualifications, etc., I don't even know where to begin.
Fuck qualifications.
I don't know. In the UK, though, do you need them?
Mm-mm.
No?
Just start working with dogs. Give Jimmy a call. See what he did. What's Jimmy's company's name? Yeah. Look up Jimmy. Jimmy the dog trainer. Next.
Bound to find him. Maddie, to add to my line, I already read that. Jamie, I was afraid to try a remote collar for punishment without conditioning my dog to the collar first. Heard y'all say, bullshit, you can use it as a punisher. Got a different dog now. Thanks.
Yep, you sure can. But more lies. More lies are being spread. Next.
Imagine that if you had to teach every command before you could punish for, like, counter-serving.
Yeah.
It's like, wait 6 weeks, buddy.
We talked about that at this weekend seminar.
I know.
Dog trainers are lying.
It's crazy.
That's why so many dog trainers hate me, because I'm telling the truth, and they're like, I'm ruining it. I'm the one that's going to ruin shock collar. So I'm like, no, it's not. All you guys arguing with each other, that's what's ruining the dog training.
Mm-hmm.
They don't get it.
No.
They just don't get it. Did you put Pat's testimonial up yet?
No, the haters one?
Yeah.
No, that's scheduled for tomorrow.
Can you give me a photo of her, though, so I can at least put the...
Oh, right here in your SD card.
Oh,
you
okay,
have
okay.
Not put into your computer. My job is done.
Go ahead.
Exactly.
Next. Jeff's getting school tonight.
Sure is. Joelle doesn't feel good, and she's tired. There's a whole list of other things that we won't get into it. Melanie, Lucky was on his place after our first in-house e-collar session. We learned a ton this weekend.
Awesome.
Nice.
Proud of you.
Scaredy Floof, hello J&J. My roommate has an out-of-control dog. There are no consequences for bad behavior. No expectations for timely obedience. He'll repeat sit over and over until the dog decides to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Roommate is overwhelmed by the idea of putting in more work due to anxiety and depression. Is it worth trying to help them if he's not going to keep up the
dog? No, it's not. It's time for you to move. Next.
Edgar is great. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I don't know why this is it right now.
Because we didn't advertise the show. Ask all your questions, guys. Let's see. What else is happening here? You put up some really for that meme you put up. That meme, that little soundbite of the flight. If you haven't been to Instagram in the last 2 hours,
I was so tan in that video. I missed my tan.
Jump in. We can go to a tanning booth. We can go tonight still. Do you want
to? Bad for you though. I try not to do that.
Okay. Well then, spray on tan.
I could.
Rub on tan. Like, what do you want to do? We can go to the gym tonight.
Move to the islands.
Go ahead and move. Go ahead and move. I'll buy you a one-way ticket, baby.
Okay. I can still do all your social media. Send me the videos.
You know what? Almost every day you mention that.
What?
Going to the islands.
No, I haven't.
We've been away for 5 days and you've said it 4 times.
No, I haven't.
Okay. Let's see. We're doing a seminar in the islands coming up. We are going to be doing one in Hawaii. We're excited about New Zealand. We're excited about New Zealand, Australia, and Singapore. A lot of people are like, and so here's a good thing. So I'm doing all three of those with Australia, I just booked it with no host. I just like found a place to do it and I'm just taking a chance on it.
Have you ever done that?
Oh yeah, I do it all the time. Mm. Yeah, that's what I do. You know, I like to take a chance. I just fight like hell to get tickets.
Take a chance, Gellman.
Yep, that's it. It's so funny how people are like still like they still talk shit about these seminars. It's like, do you think all these people are like being
held against their will?
Wait until you like just watch the
better come to the seminar this weekend.
Just read the it's so funny. It's like read the testimonials of the people that are actually there.
Yeah, over and over and over again.
It's like it's incredible. Mm-hmm. It's incredible. It's beautiful. What else do we got?
Let's see. JW, what's your next topic for revamp DIY series?
We just talked about that the other day.
We're going to do the handoff.
We're going to do it. Yeah, we're just going to do how to head off an aggressive dog. But I think what we're going to do is...
We still have recall.
We can do recall, which is a little bit more complicated. But I think we might want to do... I think we want to start working on... heel. I think we can do that. We can break that up. Yeah. I think we can talk about proper collar placement. I think we can talk about proper leash positioning, proper body positioning, mm-hmm. and then we can start working on like dog positioning. Yeah. And then we also can do one on troubleshooting as well, forging ahead.
Oh, yeah,
the stuff that you use. I mean, literally, like healing could be like a five Series one.
Easily.
Yeah. So we'll start doing that. You know, but it's gonna take a little bit unless we do something for the road.
We need a dog.
We'll have five dogs with us.
Oh, our dogs. Got it.
Yeah. Yeah. We have five dogs. We have five dogs in the RV. So yeah. Next.
Let's see. There's a lot here now. Kyle, thanks guys. I've been showing off my clip on your Facebook page.
Awesome. Good.
Alicia, we've actually been to therapy many, many, many times. It's frustrating for the both of us to bring up the dog training topic.
That's why you go to therapy.
I guess though. I just have to stick with it and see if she'll change her interaction.
No.
I'll stick with therapy, yes.
Yeah, okay. First of all.
Maybe.
Okay. If the hardest thing at therapy, and if you've been going for a while, is the dog stuff, that's the focus of the therapy. If your therapist is good, see, this is the problem. You both want to win. That doesn't work that way. Couples, the goal of therapy, the goal of a disagreement between couples is go into it without wanting to win. Go into it with, we're going to work it out. So there's no like, I'm going to be right. I'm going to be right. I'm going to win. I'm going to win. I want you to lose. It's like, it won't work that way. You need to find a therapist that understands these concepts. And just like dog trainers, all therapists are not the same. Find a new therapist. But if that's your big struggling point, that's what you go to therapy for. That's what you concentrate on. Or get the fuck out of the relationship. End of story. If it was drinking or promiscuity or lying or drug use or like something else, it's like those are usually deal breakers. Well, guess what? This may, and it sounds like, is a deal breaker. So it's either taken care of and settled or the relationship is over. Oh my God, Jeff, you're telling somebody to break up with somebody over their dogs? Yeah.
If it's the only thing you fight about.
If you guys can't get constantly. Fucking, if you guys can't figure out, first of all, it's like, what is making your partner go against you? Mm-hmm. It is a form of abuse. It is a form of abuse. No, she loves the dog. No. She's hurting you.
That's just her way to do it.
That's her way to do it. It's manipulative. It's passive, it's aggressive manipulation.
Yeah. It's so much deeper.
It's not a dog issue. It's guys like this whole dog thing is way deeper. It's not about the fucking dogs.
Yeah.
So this relationship, okay? This relationship is not about her love of dogs. It's about her blatant hurting of you. Why? Why? Mm-hmm. Why is she doing this? Why does she want to see you hurt? Something for you guys to talk about. Next.
Woo! Getting deep tonight.
Well,
I know. I lived it. I get it.
And I live it.
And I have massive empathy for you.
Yes. I don't live it personally, but it's like, this is what I do.
Yeah.
People are like, everybody's like, you need good dog skills. No, you need good fucking human skills. That's why I can do seminars. That's why I fucking have so many good results, is because my understanding of humans and emotion, and I read between the lines and I understand intent, but I also have massive empathy and care. And for all these people that are like, oh, you must really love dogs. What are you, fucking nuts? Yeah, dogs are good, but dogs are my fucking in. Dogs are my Trojan horse into humans. Because I love humans. Mm-hmm. And I want humans to have the best life ever. We live one time. Life is short. Make it fucking good.
Seriously.
Next.
Who does your partner kiss first when she comes home?
Well, you already know that fucking answer.
I know, but I just want to, I'm just crossing my T's, dotting my I's here. Jared, how do I know if my dog is licking through OCD or trying to make himself throw up? I can bring them outside while he's in a licking fit. He'll eat a bunch of grass like his stomach hurts.
That's just more OCD stuff. This is how you know.
It's repeating a cycle.
Yeah, you make it suck and see if it stops. Next.
Alicia, with the dogs, but if not, then I guess bye-bye. So sad.
Yep.
Yeah. Ryan, regarding the email, I still sent it, hoping for an answer because I was asking for a name, and I know you don't mention names in public.
Thanks for everything. Got it. That's different. And that's if I know one.
Leah, what is the biggest difference in your opinion between mini educator and dog trial? Why would I choose one over the other?
I used to train on dog trials. That's because eCower wasn't around. eCower was formed by one of the founders of Tritonics. His name is Greg. He's a really good guy. Dog trials stopped. They stopped. Their customer service started falling down. eCower technology has a great product. Their customer service is stellar. Their customer service is still set stellar. From what I understand, the Dogtra also, you couldn't buy direct. You had to buy through a wholesaler or a distributor. It was too much trouble. I believe now it's easier to order from Dogtra. So now I would say, what do you like to train on? They both have different stim patterns. Mm-hmm. If a client comes in with a Dogtra, we'll use their Dogtra. But we stock and prefer the mini educator. But that would be personal choice on that one. Next.
Scaredy Floof, I put off bringing my dog here. He's staying with my parents because of the roommate's dog, but I have free rent here right now.
And so free rent, so get a second job. Sorry. It's like people stick around for a job for the retirement plan and health care. It's like, okay, well, fine. I mean, yeah, I get it, but life is more, happiness is more important.
So much more important, you guys.
Okay? Drive Uber one night a week, that pays for rent. Rent a room for $300 to $400 a month. That's you driving Uber one night a week. There's always an alternative. There's always an alternative. To me, free rent and being stressed out about, and also your dog can't even live with you. Is that what he said?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You can't live with your dog and you're stressed out about your roommate's dog, but you get free rent. Not worth it. My book. Mm-mm. Next.
Alicia says, how do you emotionally handle a divorce? It's honestly so devastating.
Anybody that says divorce is easy, is full of shit.
Yeah.
With Joelle, Joelle had me. So, yeah, I helped her a lot.
She thought we were doing a lot of dumb shit,
yeah.
too.
Yeah, so literally, I think I was probably the first one that knew about it. Mm-hmm. Well, besides him.
Yeah.
And you.
Yeah.
And the girl he was banging, you know. So.
She knew.
She knew. But there's bigger issues than that anyway.
Yeah.
And Joelle has shared her story on many times. Yeah. And it's not for me.
But it was like, once you're out, you realize how like abusive and toxic it really is.
And when you surround yourself with positive people.
Yeah, it makes it a lot.
You need to find a circle of people who don't not feel bad for you and don't turn, I don't know, is that a male, if you're a male or female, or my audience is mixed up
guys, I have like a cold thing.
Of both men and women, and they all have either male or female spouses, lovers, partners. The demographics is all over the board. I skew high in the female with my listeners, but it's difficult. But you know, and then having kids is even more difficult. But how do you do it? It's you know, knowing that I suggest getting into therapy, and you know, knowing that whatever pain you're in now is temporary,
yeah.
And you will you do and you can get over it. Some people don't, and then also knowing that there's a really great life out there waiting for you. That doesn't mean a person. That means a great life,
yeah.
For yourself. So
you get to become really selfish, which is cool.
Yep. Next.
Teresa, my mother watched the replay from last Wednesday that I sent her. She is hooked now and finally started correcting bad behavior in her dog.
Nice. Proud of you. And Teresa's mom, I'm super proud of you. Big shout out to you. Next.
Married Meeks, what about a dog that does not stop when punished with the e-collar? He has a working level and flinches and then continues whatever is being corrected.
You shouldn't be correcting on a working level. You should be correcting on a punishment level, which is much higher. How higher? How higher? How high? High enough for the dog to stop. Next.
Tim, I like my dog to do an alert bark of people approaching house. How can I allow that but prevent excessive barking after the alert bark?
So allow one bark and then say quiet. Next.
Michelle, break. Can you please discuss break in one of your DIY vids? Why do we need it? How do you get your dog to understand it? Everyone uses it, but no one shows how.
We show how all the time.
Yeah. We only reward after break. So it becomes like a...
You don't have to use the word break. Break is a release command. Mm-hmm. The activity is over. So how do you train it? Put the dog on a leash. Say, put the dog is in down.
Still have to do a marker tip of the day.
Yep. Say, break! And then pull the dog out and then back up and give it food. There you go. It learns break. Next.
We got to do markers.
But that's it right there. That's how you teach break. Next.
Melanie, pre-walk bonk. Can you explain and remind me of purpose? Getting attention on me so he doesn't scan?
Yes. Next.
Kyle, thanks guys. I've noticed whilst walking my GSD on leash lately, people avoid me like the plague. He's 75 pounds at 9 months old, so he isn't a small dog, but I don't understand why people walk out of their way. It's like they assume my dog is aggressive.
I don't know.
I like that. That's like ideal for me when people get out of
my
way.
Maybe you have resting bitch face, Kyle. Right? Smile. I don't know. It's not the worst. It's not the worst thing in the world that your dog that your dog is avoid that people are avoiding you. Don't worry about it. That's on them, not you. Next.
Elsie, hey J&J, would you talk about how to hold a leash short and close while walking?
Yes, I do all the time, but that'll be part of the video on healing. Next.
Jay, just had a great evening walk tonight. Watched a dog walked by us, reared up on their hind legs, growling while my dog sat politely. Thanks for your help.
You're welcome. Wow.
Nice. Jamie, my dog is far too interested in the treat bag on my hip than whatever we are training for. How do I get him focused on success of the action rather than the treat?
Stop using food. Put the food bag behind you.
Behind you.
Stick the food in your pockets. Keep your hands off the food. Usually that's handler error. You're giving a command with your hand in the bag. Historically, that's what happens. So food is a reward. Food is after the dog has done something right. So at a minimum, put the treat bag behind you.
Put it in your pockets.
You know? Yeah, or put food in your pockets.
They're making new ones now that can go in like hoodie pockets.
Yep. They're pretty cool, actually, yes. Yep.
Alicia, laughed my ass off, but I know I'm right, though. Haha, and I get your point. Thanks.
What are you talking about?
With the dog stuff.
Oh, yes.
Veronica, can you help me understand the difference between advocating for my dog around strangers versus walking my dog through his fear? Thanks for all you do. Love what you're doing.
It's sort of the same thing. So advocating for your dog, it's sort of during the council we were doing socialization with this boarding facility, which, by the way, Fetchers in Fargo, North Dakota is a fantastic facility to board your dog. They have a groomer there. It's a wonderful place. They do daycare. Really great. It's wonderful.
It's gorgeous.
Oh, my gosh. What a great facility. What a great facility. So advocating for your dog and working your dog through fear, you actually do it. That's actually how you work your dog through fear, by advocating for your dog. So what you do is you move forward through the fearful thing, and you make sure you keep your dog in a proper heel, and you make sure you keep your dog safe. Your dog then eventually just goes, so that signboard is nothing to be afraid of. That planter is nothing to be afraid of. That garbage truck is nothing to be afraid of. If they break heel, you correct them. Oh, I'm correcting my dog for being afraid. No, you're correcting your dog for breaking heel. And then now a lot of people say, oh no, use food to associate the dog with something good. Guys, if you ever work with a fearful dog, it doesn't take food. If it takes food, it ain't that afraid. Next.
Jamie, marriage isn't 50-50, it's 100-100.
Possibly. Next.
Tony, love you guys. How do I correct my stubborn pity boxer from getting on the couch? He only goes on when we aren't there.
So your dog breaks out of the crate and jumps on the couch? Next.
Snark. Kyle, at 9 months old now and being avoided by other dog owners, does my GSD, which is well socialized as a puppy, still need to be meeting new dogs every day?
Never. No. I shouldn't say never. No, it does not. No.
Especially now that it's starting to be reactive.
Yeah, so keep your dog, stay in your lane right now. Stay in your lane. Next.
Alicia, yes, I love all beings deeply.
Next.
Jared, normally the only way I can stop him from licking is putting hydrogen peroxide in his mouth and make him throw up. Then he seems completely fine, then just goes to sleep.
Okay. Stop trying to make him throw up. Yeah. Just correct it. Okay, do this. Go to the vet, get a vet check. If the vet gives him a clean bill of health, like I've seen 99.99.99% of the dogs do, just correct it. Next.
Jay, my dog is walking pretty well on the leash. How do I start working on off-leash walk?
You remote collar, heel, leash in the pocket, and start using, rely less on the leash and more on the remote collar stem. To at the beginning, you guide your dog back into heel with the remote collar and the leash, and eventually the remote collar does the work. Next.
Marianne, thanks for being a people advocate.
You're welcome. Yeah. People are great. People are fantastic. It's unusual in the dog industry to find people that like to find people in the industry that like people. Most of them like dogs. That's why they got to the dog world. They actually despise people. So if you're looking for a dog trainer, find one that actually gives a shit about people. Next.
Britt, I think my boyfriend is jealous of my dog, but I'm the one training the dog. And how can we show off our dogs?
Why would you want to show off your dog?
I don't know. All the cool shit they can do.
Make your video. I mean, don't send it to me. I don't want to see your dog.
Is the boyfriend jealous of the fact that you have a well-behaved dog?
Yeah, I don't. What do you mean? Show? I don't understand what that question is.
I don't know either.
Don't show off your dog. Maybe it's the wrong choice of words. Help me out here on that one. So, show off to us, show off to the people on my show. That's not what the show is about. So, you know, as far as your boyfriend's jealous of the dog, mm-hmm. Because you give the dog more attention than the boyfriend, maybe. Well, that's a couple's issue that you need to communicate with. Next.
Bronwyn, I would love to hear more about your work before coming into the dog industry and how you got into the industry.
Bronwyn, I talk about it all the time. I own a company called Miko Exotic Wear. I owned it for 15 years. I started it with zero. I built it up to a $3.5 million company. I was in the sex toy business. I was the largest importer of silicone sex toys in the country for all the ladies out there that are using sex toys, men as well. We all know that most sex toys were made out of jelly latex or that cyber material. But we all know, you should know that it's dangerous for you. It has cancer-causing ingredients.
What is jelly latex?
That's what the latex is. Jelly latex is what most sex toys are out of. If you go into any sex shop, most stuff is jelly latex. If you go into a other sex shop that has usually non-pornography packaging, mm-hmm. it's usually designed really nice. It reminds you of almost like Apple products. It's silicone.
So they're still using the other stuff?
Oh, God, yeah. A ton of it.
Isn't it that's really bad for
you? It's cancer-causing ingredient, but it's really cheap to manufacture. But silicone is actually coming up. So we were the first importers in the United States to import it, and we distributed it. I used to do the big, huge sex shows. I traveled the world. I went to Germany, the Netherlands. I went to Denmark. I worked directly with a manufacturer in Denmark. We imported stuff.
So you're the first.
Yeah, the first.
How come no one gives you recognition?
Why would they give me recognition?
Because you're the first.
Who gives a flying fuck?
The first to bring safe sex products into the U.S.
But nobody cares. Next.
I'm sure there's a lot of people who care.
Yep. Yeah.
Dog, all right, I don't know what this name is. Thad, maybe. Dog is great at classes with other dogs. Great with the trainer, then reactive with us and the other dogs on the leash on walks in the neighborhood.
Say it one more time.
All right.
Yes.
Dog is great at dog class.
Yes. Typical.
Great with the trainer.
Typical.
Then reactive with us and other dogs on the leash on walks in their neighborhood.
Typical.
Ignores prong, will choke herself. Bonker time?
No. Okay. The job of every dog trainer is not to be good with the dog. The job of every dog trainer is to empower the human to get the same results as you. So what do? You should do the pre-walk bonk. What's the pre-walk bonk? You actually, as soon as you walk out that front door, and if that dog is scanning, no bonk. Okay? Now, remote collar on the dog. And you want to start making sure you're applying your punisher, your correction, call it what you want. It's the first sign of arousal. Okay. Also, it could be the way you're holding the leash, your body position, your breathing, your state of mind. There's many, many things that it takes to get a good walk from a dog. All right. Also, do not go into the worst part of the area where your dog explodes. Go up and down your driveway till you perfect a good walk. Then go two houses down, two houses back, two houses down, two houses back. Make sure you get that walk under control prior to you getting out there. Next.
Chris, hi Jeff. I'm rehabbing a 4-year-old rescue French Mastiff that is dog reactive. I've been training daily with a prong. Do you have any advice bridging the gap to socialization? Video suggestions?
I've got tons of advice, none that I would give online because there's too many variables, and if it's done wrong, you have a dog fight and it's a Mastiff. So that is a Skype session, and I'm not saying that because I want you to purchase a Skype, but it would be unethical for me to give you advice other than muzzle up the dog because there's way too many variables. I also don't know your skill set, and I don't know the dog, and I don't know the other dogs that you'll be socializing it with. And if there's any other humans in the room, I don't know anything about them, their energy, or their skill set. Next.
Alicia, but you might like to hear that I got my 3-year-old male pit mix to sit 5 times on our walk. I was so proud of him. He never sits outdoors, always used to scan obsessively.
Awesome. Proud of you. Next.
Kyle, I was planning on keeping my GSD crated forever, pretty much. However, I keep being told he's at the age he should be left alone roaming the downstairs of the house when I'm not in. I don't like the idea of this. Is this a normal practice?
Okay, so whoever told you that is stupid. And I would stop listening to every piece of advice they ever give, because I would love someone to take my Malinois home and let it free roam all over their house. I would love to have somebody take Kira home and let it free roam all over their house. I would love it. I guarantee you, if my dog dies, I want $50,000 minimum. Are you willing to put that up? Because my dog will probably eat something or do something. Well, why don't you stop it, Jeff? I do. I crate my dogs. I make my life easy. I crate my dogs. Mm-hmm. It's like, it's simple. Crate your dog. Well, why don't you like train it to not eat every single thing? I could do that. I can keep my dog off counters. I can keep my dog out of trash cans. I can do all that. Am I willing to risk the life of my dog for that? Meanwhile, Joelle's dog, before she moved into the center, she left her dog out all the time and it didn't eat anything. And it was fine. That's her dog. My dog? No. Did she do any better training than I've done? No. She just owned a dog that she could do that with. Kyle, you might own that dog. I don't know. But are you willing to risk the life of your dog to find out? And at 9 months old, I would say no. Mm-mm. I would say no. So they've never come home to their dog barely breathing on the ground, scooped it up, rushed to the emergency room at 2 a.m., knowing that their dog had to get split open, and it cost them $4,000 to remove something, and the dog still didn't learn its lesson. They don't know what that feels like. They don't know what it's like to come home to a dog that got into a small potato chip bag and ate the potato chips and realized all of a sudden the more they keep their nose in the bag, they're losing oxygen, but they keep eating, they keep breathing in and out and in and out, and their nose is stuck into it, and eventually the dog passes out and the bag doesn't come off and the dog loses oxygen. And you come home after 15 minutes from running to the store to your dog dead on the ground with a potato chip bag on its nose. I guess they've never seen that happen before. They've never come home to a ripped up couch. They've never come home to name it. So tell them to shut the fuck up, mind their own goddamn business, go rescue a dog from a shelter. They can let it do what they want it to do, but you, I suggest, crate your dog. And that wasn't even a rant. Hashtag truth. Next.
Amal, hi Jeff, how do I use my e-collar to stop barking at the doorbell? Also jumping at my wife when she comes near me at times.
Okay, so jumping the doorbell is easy. Dog jumps, make it suck. Dog jumps on your wife, keep a leash on it, hold back a little bit, and then correct, make it suck.
Bronwyn, how do you go from sex toys to dog training?
I was tired of the industry. So I was in it for 15 years. I led seminars. I actually did sex education seminars. I also ran an S&M night at a local club. I did fetish parties. I did a fetish boat. I set up at swingers parties. I did a lot of stuff. I was in the industry. I did extremely well. Why? I ran it like a business. But I also did seminars, and I did seminars on everything from S&M 101 to oral sex to you know, anal sex 101, to female ejaculation, to, you know, what sex toys are. I spoke at universities. Brown University paid me to speak at their women's studies group. But it was all about empowering and helping people.
Man, I wish we had social media like back then.
Yeah, and primarily.
We didn't document any of this shit.
No, and primarily females. Now, I'm actually doing the same thing now. I am helping people. Believe it or not, I am doing something extremely, extremely similar. I'm helping people. Now, so what I did was I was tired of it. I was burnt out. I was stressed. I was overworked. I got a dog, and I had lots of problems with my dog. And I was the naive dog owner that everybody else is that is now. And I was able to find somebody eventually. I've gone told this story about Max many times to help me with my dog. And then someone saw my dog and said, "Wow, sort of like you, Kyle. Wow, you know, you've got a great dog here. Can you help me with my dog?" And I said, "Yes." So I started helping people's dogs, started for free, pay what you can. I'm good at business, so I was able to build up a business. And I said, as soon as I start generating $500 a week, going from $3.5 million a year to $500 a week, I'm giving up my companies. And some I shut down, some I sold, not for big money, but some I liquidated, okay, by choice. And I got up to $500 a week and I stopped it. Boom, we're done. All my leases were up. Some of them I got out of. Some of them I just eventually paid off. I got out of it and $500, and I built that up into a seven-figure company right now. And now I tour the world doing dog training seminars. How did I do it? I've been working my fucking face off since I was 9 years old. That's how I did it. I didn't get lucky. I've been working my fucking face off. Hard work. Smart work. But I've made a lot of mistakes. And I didn't have anybody to guide me like we have now. There was no internet to like learn things from. Everything was a secret. Next.
I freaking wish you had a Joelle back then.
Mm-hmm.
Speaking of Brown today on anal sex.
Yep. Yeah.
Social media gold.
Yeah. It would be.
You have no video, nothing. Newspaper articles?
Oh yeah, well there's newspaper articles because I was interviewed, yeah, a lot. Huh. Yep. I was interviewed a lot. We won the best place for sexy gifts 15 years in a row.
Damn.
Yep. We were the only place.
And you were in that little building on the corner?
The Miko building, yeah. We were the only place where you can get a triple wide size 13E high heel pump in with a 4-inch heel.
Size 13.
Well, cross-dressers.
Yeah.
We had a huge cross-dresser business. God. Yep.
Pretty cool shit.
Yep.
Jamie, free roaming versus crazy. You had so many businesses, though. Didn't you sell, like, carts? Like, wagon wheels or some shit?
No, I own the Providence Pushcart Company.
And you sold pantyhose and hair ties?
I had a pantyhose delivery company.
Shitty businessman through
and through. Yeah, people would fax me their orders in the financial district. So ladies, you know, maybe it's not as popular now because of different dress codes and different dressing styles, but you get a tear.
No, mine would always tear at work.
You get a tear in your pantyhose and there's no place to buy them.
Yep.
What do? You fill out a form. This is before email, right? You fill out a form, you fax it to me, within 30 minutes or less, I show up with your fucking pantyhose.
It's genius.
Yeah.
I would just have to take mine off, but.
Yeah. Well, you didn't. I don't want to know about that. So yeah, I did that. Yep.
Yeah. It's great.
Yep.
And
we had pantyhose up into a 4XL, I believe. 4XL. Yep. We carried Hanes. I know everything about denier. We carried 10 to 10. Well, we do 80, but those were Hugh brand leggings. So, but 10 are the really thin ones. We had to wear gloves. You have to wear cotton gloves.
Wait, I don't
gloves.
Understand that concept.
10 was...
They're just going to tear by looking at them.
No, they did. 10 were...
Why would you wear them?
We imported them from France.
Yep.
Those were stockings.
You needed
a garter belt.
Yeah.
Yeah, they had the Cuban heel. So...
That's like for photo shoots and...
Yeah.
The bedroom.
Yeah.
You don't wear those.
Well, if anybody knows anywhere. Dita Vantees.
Yeah.
So Dita Vantees is like, I used to see her all the time at the seminars. Yeah. Yep.
You have so many interesting stories.
Yep.
Jamie, free roaming versus crating. If mine free roam while I was gone, I wouldn't have any pillows left in my house.
There you go. Next.
Jojo, my dog, Pitbull mix, 4 years old, always whines and destroys things whenever we leave her alone, and I'm going to start crating her soon. What do I do to stop whining while in the crate?
Remote collar, do it at home first, put a bark collar on the dog, get an ultra sensitive one. Next.
Rosie, I use shock collar with my dog, but he has been abused with it before. He sometimes responds with it, and other times he is scared, and then he shuts down. How do I use a different approach?
Okay, so this is it. We don't know if he was abused, and maybe you do know, but I like to say there's a general statement because most people assume, but they actually don't factually know. And if the rescue said that he was, you don't know that because rescues lie. Just let's put it out there. Rescues lie. I have used a remote collar on dogs who have been used improper. It does take a skill set. You have to do a new association, tons of food, lots of training. You have to also know dog training. Guys, keep in mind, there is a skill set to remote collar use. I challenge anybody to just use a remote collar and teach that dog a downstay without knowing dog training. Now, you don't just be pushing buttons. So that's what we teach, you know, at our training center. That's what we teach at our seminars. So how do you get the dog used to it? Have it on the dog, tons of food, lower levels, layer leash pressure over it. Next.
And Lee, hi from Singapore, Jeff and Joelle, love all your content, learn so much. Thank you.
And Lee, Jeff Gellman Seminars, jeffgellmanseminars.com. I'm doing a seminar at Ben's place in Singapore. I will be in Singapore in July of 2020. Get your ticket. It will sell out because it's a small venue.
Next. Are we doing...
Last.
It's last.
Okay. So we're doing New Zealand, Australia, Singapore.
Makes sense.
So we're flying from the U.S. to New Zealand. Once we're in New Zealand, it's going to be easier flights. Then the Singapore home is a longer flight.
Yeah.
Yes. And then we're going to be doing a separate one in other, probably in Europe, like the U.K. Next.
Gee, ever since using the prong and obedience training, his reactivity towards people has dramatically improved.
Yes.
She can now sit, down, stay while people and bikes pass by. This happened within about 3 weeks.
Yep, that sounds about right. And this is the thing, guys.
Oh, hold on, there's more.
I'm sorry.
It was pretty dramatic change with people, but why do you think it's taking longer to desensitize her around dogs? Either way, I'm not giving up, and it will take as long as she needs.
So dogs are the same species. Dogs just might have, it's just, okay, why? Because it's harder to do sometimes. That's why. And I also don't know your skill set. Next.
Kyle, yeah, excellent point. He'll be staying crated. Thanks for the advice.
Good decision, Kyle.
Karen, GSD lover. Hey, Joelle, do you still let your dog free roam? No, because we're like
he's
at the training center now.
Oh, so. Yeah, to you, Joelle? Sorry. I apologize. Yeah.
No, so they're kenneled a lot, actually. They spend like the majority of their day in their kennel. Yeah.
They live at the training center because Joelle lives there because she's smart. And she'll be buying a house soon but not living in it. So think about this. So for all the folks out there, Joelle... we'll be buying a house, but not living in the house. She's going to generate revenue from that house on Airbnb and still live in the training center. So she's going to start acquiring real estate, but not living in it while she lives for free and let her money work for her.
It's always been a dream of mine. Pretty exciting.
It's smart.
Yeah.
So she's looking at cabins in the Catskills. She's thinking about investing it down in a Florida house because I've got a management team already down there. Mm-hmm. So she's always looking at stuff. So it's really smart to do. It's really smart to do.
And next. Owning a house is a pain in the ass anyway.
Right. And you're never home.
I'm never home.
And you're never home between work and travel.
Yep.
Next.
Britt, I'm thinking about bonking my dog in the back because a small dog's neighbor barks all the time. Then my dog reacts. So where... do you get the strings to tie it? Strings for what? What do you need strings for?
Say it one more time.
I'm thinking about bonking my dog in the back because a small dog neighbor's dog barks all the time. Then my dog reacts.
Oh.
So where do I get the strings? Oh,
yeah, they're elastics. They're 64 elastics. Next.
Gee, I already read that. Amali says thank you. Kyle, also my vet hates the idea of me feeding my dog raw. He's been raw fed since 12 weeks. I know there's not much I can do to change their mind, but how do I deal with this?
Say that one more time. I'm spacing.
The vet doesn't approve of raw.
Oh, who gives
Pay
a fuck?
Attention. Okay.
Who cares what the vet thinks? Who cares what your vet thinks about its diet?
It's hard to find a vet that doesn't approve.
Okay, vets what? Vets can suggest what? Science, diet, or Hills?
Purina.
The last thing I would ask a vet is about nutrition.
Yeah.
Next.
Alicia, does a leash pop work with any collar or does it have to be a prong?
Well, it doesn't work as effective. But I mean, a leash pop on a flat buckle collar sort of doesn't do much. I mean, it chokes the dog. You can get, you're causing traumatic neck injury to the dog. Next.
Gee, you guys are the bomb.
Thanks.
Chris, videos have been great. Are there any dog trainers in or around Vancouver, Canada that you might know or can recommend by chance? I've been looking, but many of them seem to use positive only training. Apologies for two questions.
Yeah, privately email me that. Let me think about it. Next.
One big weirdo. My dog has been house trained the last year that we've had her and has all of a sudden started peeing in the house. Should I bonk for this behavior or go back to the basics with house training again?
Yes. The second one. Go back to the basics. Next.
Mikkel, hey guys, first live. I tried a prong collar for my great peer, Akbash Mix, 6 months old. Big puppy.
I can't imagine not using a prong collar on that
dog. So far, it's worked wonders, and my blisters from leash pulling are gone.
Ooh. Wow, nice.
Cool.
Next.
Dark Horse. My GSP is guarding her food. She knows out, but won't eat. She just keeps growling at me, and if I'm anywhere near her, I get her out of the crate. She wags her tail like she's playing, but won't stop growling.
So I correct that. Correct it. Back the dog up. Yep. So I don't want just physical disengagement. I want mental disengagement without. You're probably underwhelming your dog. Next.
Lene, family says I need to let the older dog correct him as long as there's no blood. What the fuck do I do?
If that older dog is capable of it, but how about if it's not? Are you prepared to break up a dog fight? Next.
James, Stormy, 18-week-old Bell Lab mix. Been on prong collar for 3 weeks and it's great. Amazing change. I never would have used a prong if not for you guys. Thanks for all you do.
We awesome. Love you. Thank you.
Educar.
It's so funny how people say that I'm destroying the industry, but little do they know that I'm historically correct.
Yeah.
It's so funny. Yeah. It's so funny. The amount of hate that we get, and people have no idea how accurate we are.
Yeah.
None
of these people, like, are here against their will.
I can't comprehend. It's just so funny.
Yeah, we're paying these people to say this shit.
No, but it's so funny because it's like, and everyone thinks all the hate right now is from pure positive. It's not. It's from the balanced training.
It's bad.
Guys, the balanced trainers right now are out of control. That's why it's hard for me to recommend anybody now, because it's like enemies at the gate.
People who you thought were like
colleagues,
yeah,
are like talking the worst trash about me. I'm like, Jesus Christ, guys.
Yeah.
When did you, like, I used to break bread with you. I used to sit down at tables with you. I've been out to dinner with you. I've met your kids. And all of a sudden, it's like, oh my God. Like, what is going on out there?
You're an easy target.
But it's like, Jesus Christ.
It's easy to,
you know, the jealousy is a sin. Like, control yourselves. I love people that I'm not going to name any particular religions here because I don't want to offend anybody, yeah, but I love how people on their public, on their private pages, like, literally spout that they are like, practicing whatever, but then have hate. Like, I'm pretty sure you shouldn't be doing that.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure everyone should just be working on themselves.
Yeah. It's like,
make the world a better place, guys.
But if it's like, don't put that on your page and then behave that way.
Don't be a hypocrite.
Because words are words, but actions are actions. And I believe your actions.
Yes. Agreed.
Okay?
It's easy to history, say the right thing.
Right. Anybody can say the right thing. Prove it. Yes. Okay. Actions, prove it. Mm-hmm. Next.
100%. Kyle, I'm now giving serious thoughts into dog training. I'd love to do something I love as a living.
Do it. Kyle. Do it. Grab a neighbor's dog, train it, document it, put it up on social media. Do it. Next.
Ed says, when are you coming to Brazil?
When Raquel invites me. Next.
Yeah, what the heck, Raquel? Kicking a dead cat. My dog knows all the basic commands, but I'd like him to stay in place longer. What would you recommend?
Make sure your dog knows place. Watch my place video. After a couple of hundred times of successfully doing in place, now when the dog breaks place, you have to learn how to apply a punisher. So more reward doesn't keep a dog in place, but the properly applied punisher when breaking place will keep the dog in place. Next.
Kyle, in the UK, people hate correcting dogs, which is ridiculous. I walk around with the best behaved German Shepherd in my area because of corrections for bad behavior.
Yep.
What the fuck are people thinking?
So
I don't think I'd do well in my region as a trainer that used correction and not positive base.
You're wrong, Kyle.
People need you.
I would love to have a business in the UK. Do you know why? Just for what you said. There's so many people that hate correcting. But guess what? I do Skypes with people in the UK every week. The demand there is huge, huge. Why? Because nobody's doing it. Mm-hmm. Got it? The demand is huge. Next.
What's going on up there?
I don't know.
My God. Alicia. Yeah, I see all the progress that you guys make and the change you make in people's lives. It's amazing. When I first started watching your stuff, my wife said it was bullshit too, but our dogs have gotten better, so whatever. I'll just keep it on.
Yeah, it's like, tell your wife I love her. Sold another New Zealand ticket tonight.
Cool, it's going to be a big one.
Yeah, New Zealand's going to be huge.
I can't wait.
Yes.
All the accents.
I know. So, this is the thing. So many people are like your wife, but guess what? I'm being historically correct. It's just the way it is. I mean, so I think a lot of people just don't like my directness, my semi rudeness, my
confidence.
Sometimes I get cocky. They misinterpret cockiness for confidence. They don't like my directness. Mm-hmm. They don't like that I swear.
Yep.
They don't like I
don't like that you make light of some things.
Some light
of,
yeah, they're
serious all the time.
Right, and they don't like the fact that like I talk about the sex industry, like yep. It's any big deal. It's like it's 2019. Okay. It's like if you don't masturbate, I don't trust you, you know?
How did you get on this planet?
You know, so it's not even about that. Well, that's procreation for procreation's sake. Yes. But that's different, okay? So
it had to happen.
But it's just really, really funny. It's like, what? How could you call yourself a professional talk like that? Well, number one, this is an entertainment show. Number two, yeah. I don't talk or act like this in my business because I can't because of, I'm not allowed to. Even with Joelle, I don't act like this.
Nope.
Like, I don't act like this with Joelle. I cannot be snarky and sarcastic, and she cannot bust my balls in the workplace either. So, I mean, she just can't. And she understands that. So it's like, I mean, I do know how to run a business. So it's just interesting that, but I think people, they see this. And meanwhile, I can't tell you how many people have gone to a seminar. The only thing it's like, how'd you find me? My podcast. I'm like, holy shit, you still showed up? I'm blown away by people that they do a boarding train and they're like, so how did you find us? Oh, I saw one of your podcasts. I'm like, you mean the ones that I'm inappropriate on? Oh yeah, we loved you, Jeff.
Yeah.
We knew you were the trainer for me because of that.
Say it all the time.
In fact, yeah. So it's interesting. I think people are afraid to be themselves.
Yeah.
But if you're an asshole, don't be yourself. Work on yourself.
Okay? It's so funny. I just had this conversation with one of my clients this morning too. It's like, everyone is afraid to just like put themselves out there because there's just so much judgment.
Well, they
but
give
guess it, what? They're going to judge you no matter what.
Stop giving a shit.
They're going to judge you no matter what.
Stop caring what other
it's
people
a
think.
It's just a freeing feeling when you just stop giving a
yeah,
fuck.
Yeah, don't give a that's incredible.
Great.
Really, stop caring what other people think.
Seriously.
Really, can I say that again? Just stop caring what other people
stop
think.
Stop caring. Next. And be self-aware.
Yes, but be self-aware, right? Next.
Oh, man. Andrea, my one-year-old dog eats breakfast and dinner in the crate. Only in the morning does she try to bury her food while in the crate. This has been going on for a couple of weeks. Why do they do this?
Why do they do it? Because that's what dogs do. Next.
Kyle, I don't think I already read that. Christine, are you sure the balance trainers that are attacking you are trainers at all? They have actual legitimate businesses, etc.
Christine, yes, I know
for
a fact.
Yep.
I know their names, their business names, their addresses, their phone numbers, their locations. I know everything about them. They actually are. Why do they do that? Probably a lot of it's jealousy. Probably a lot of it's because they're afraid to say what needs to be said. They don't like that I give away all my information. They think by me doing well, that's why they're doing bad. They don't like my personality. They might be basing their decisions on rumor and innuendo instead of like fact. They hear things, but they don't. To me, I hear a lot of things, but I don't believe it because it's called gossip. So all I know is this: nice always wins. Nice always wins. That's it. It's the way it is. Next.
Blake, did you ever make a TikTok?
So we have Zoe on TikTok. We have an account. We have very strict instructions. She's still researching it, but we will be on TikTok by the end of September. We will be active on TikTok. Yes.
Cool. Kyle, when you do a seminar in the UK, I'll be there 100%. I'll be working by then, I'd imagine, so I'll be able to afford it. F the haters.
Yeah. It's this is the thing though, Kyle, I got to find a venue first, next, which is hard to do in the UK, in England. Scotland, I have a venue. England, I don't have a venue. Next.
Teresa, oh, I'm getting better at not caring what people think. Always a work in progress.
So Teresa, it does take work because this is it. Nobody likes to be hit. Nobody likes people saying negative things about them. Number one, can I make a suggestion? Ban and delete anybody that does. Get rid of all passive-aggressive bullshit. Don't put up with any nonsense on your page. Keep your page clean, okay? Don't get into arguments. Don't get into debates. It's a dictatorship, not a discussion, okay? On people that don't try to convince anybody what you're doing is the right way, okay? I'm not saying what I'm doing is the right way. I'm just saying it's our way. Is it the best way? It's our way, okay? Stay off of other people's pages historically. Stop watching other people's videos. Don't judge yourself by other people's, what other people are doing. Videos get edited. Also, turn off the news. What kind of great, wonderful things are you putting into your mind every day? What kind of great, wonderful things are you putting in your mind every day? Because if you're watching the news, you're fucked. Mm. If you're reading the newspaper, you're fucked. Mm-hmm. Reality TV, you're fucked. Okay, so, you know, when's the last time you listened to a motivating podcast, an audio book? When's the last time you read a book that actually challenged your brain to think positive thoughts? When's the last time you actually went to talk therapy, maybe? When's the last time you worked through some of your issues? When's the last time you actually tried to actually really troubleshoot some of your hangups? So all these things are all combined. It's not one thing. It's not one thing. And then you have to not just say it, you have to believe it. Now, does any of the negativity ever affect me? Yes, it does. Of course it does. I'm human. But it absolutely doesn't control me. I don't make any decisions based on it. It is in and out of my head. It usually is as little as, like, I would say 15 seconds is pushing it. You know what I mean? So it's like less than that. And I get it daily. And I also realize that I'm trying to fucking change the world. Mm-hmm. And there's going to be a lot of people out there that are not going to like it. And I'm okay with that. And anybody that wants to do anything big is going to get people that don't like them. And I'm not looking to make friends. I'm not looking to make enemies. But I'm sure as hell not looking to make friends. So I am on a mission. I am on a mission to make the lives of people that are struggling better. Now, right now, dogs are my Trojan horse. And that we get, oh, he only cares about business, da 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 da. It's like, no, I'm actually helping dogs too. But how do I help people right now in this stage of my life? By helping their dogs. So it's a win-win. The dogs benefit, the owners benefit. The dogs stay alive, the owners get happy. So that's what I'm doing. So I'm on a mission for that. And I'm on a mission to do it on a grand scale. So when you have a mission, and also I want to leave a certain legacy. Then when you have a legacy, you're working towards something. But there's a lot of passions that I have. So I think what you need to do is you have to stop worrying about what people think. Even your parents, which reminds me, I got to call my mom. She disagrees with a lot of what I do, like the name of my child, you know, the fact that I do certain things. I'm not here to please my mother. So, you know, and I've had to have talks with her about that. I've had to set boundaries down about that. I'm really good at boundary setting. So, you know, I think it's one of these things where it's like, what are you putting into your head on a daily basis that can make your mind better? Are you bookending your day? Are you waking up and starting your day with awesomeness? And are you ending your day with awesomeness? Okay? And then it's called bookending. And then during the day, what's going into your mind? So right now, if this was coffee, it's actually tea, herbal tea, because we're both not feeling well. If it was coffee, which is historically dark, so because I drink it black, and if this was my mind and the darkness was all of the negativity, how much clean liquid do I need to put into this cup in order to make it clear? Well, the dark liquid is the negativity that society is constantly trying to get in on us, and we need to put good stuff in. So we need to constantly be putting good stuff into our mind to overcome the negativity, or the negativity takes over. Also, most things don't matter. And if you want to do big things, so every day I'm putting out fires, every day. So I've got 25, I don't think all the seminars for 2020 are not announced, but I got about 25 seminars on the burner, meaning I've got 25 potential issues, 25 logistical issues, 25 locations, and then I've got the training center, and then I've got homes down in Florida. So it's always like, I'm always right now, it's like I'm putting out fires, they call it. So I'm a firefighter, I'm always putting out fires. But I love it. I love the rush, I love the challenge, I don't like things easy. I want things to be hard. Okay? I want things to be hard. You know, I get up at 4 o'clock in the morning, now I can't help it. Now I can't help it. It's just, it's been patterned. So if it was easy, everybody would do it. The cool part about being, if you want to become successful, is that 98% of the people out there won't do it. I love that number to be higher. Next.
I don't even know where we are anymore because that was the longest rant I think you've ever gone on.
Really? Oh, sorry. I didn't think that was a rant.
Kyle, when you do a seminar in the UK, I'll be there 100%. I already read that.
Yep.
Okay, mud footprints. How do I get my 2-year-old Doberman to drop a ball or toy? Tried high-value treats, other toys, playing dead with toy, and not making the game interesting. I get dragged in the game of tug instead of a drop.
Okay, remote collar out. Boop. Make it suck. Dog learns it in half a second. Next.
Norm, hi Jeff and Joelle. You're an inspiration to me. I keep going because of your efforts. Thanks.
Thank you. Now, let's self-inspire. Learn how to self-inspire. But I'm glad I can help. Next.
Mud footprints. I also want to say you guys are amazing.
Thank you. You're amazing too. All of you are amazing. All of you are wonderful people. Anybody tuning into my show that listens, especially listens to the whole thing, it's you. You're doing the hard work. I love you guys. I truly do. Next.
Sheila, help stop nuisance barking. I use a bonker and a word. She will still bark.
Try a bark collar. Just strap a bark collar on your dog. Oh, it's a Band-Aid. So it's a Band-Aid. Dog doesn't bark anymore. Who gives a shit? Next.
Chris sent the email for recommendations to the Solid Canine Front Desk email. Hope that's okay.
I might not get that. Next.
Kyle, I know a few places that I would imagine would be fine with you using their centers. It has to be good for their publicity, right? I could forward you some addresses.
Don't forward me the addresses, Kyle. Walk in there. Ask them if they're interested in hosting a Jeff Gellman seminar. And they need to have, this is not a sexist, chauvinistic comment, balls of steel. Okay? Once
the word gets.
Yeah. Out. Yep. So, next.
He said, my previous training school for my GSD was correction-based.
Cool.
Cool. Teresa, I agree 100%, and Paige is clean. I had a woman watching us tonight and asked for a business card for her GSD.
Cool.
It was a great feeling having another approach me because I do use an e-collar.
Good. Awesome. Yeah, people search us out because of how we train. Next.
Sheila, to add on, German Shepherd, Belgian. I've stayed the course. I love her. She loves me, but sometimes it's stupid barking. No budget for the e-collar.
Bonker. Got a budget for that. Next. No. Bonk. Next.
Melissa, we just got a 9-week-old puppy yesterday, and I've been using the bonker on him for excessive whining. He started laying down and just going to sleep instead.
Good. And now I want you to make sure you're doing a ton of food and marker, or food and clicker, which is a marker training. A ton of it. Teach every command like that. Use the dog's daily kibble if you're feeding kibble. Next.
Jay, dog seems anxious in the crate on webcam, sometimes while at work, but it's quiet, but I see he is quick to jump up at any noise. Anything to do about this?
Yeah, take the webcam and fucking unplug it and throw it in the trash. Next.
Alicia, next podcast, I'll be asking about how to successfully set boundaries.
Awesome. Okay, Alicia, let me help you out right here. You ready? Alicia, can I walk up to you and grab your boobs, yes or no? Hopefully the answer was no. Okay. If the answer is no, you have boundaries, correct? You have boundaries. So you do have boundaries, correct? There's probably other things that you have boundaries of. If I saw you driving your car, can I open up the car door and sit in your car? Hopefully you wouldn't let me. So you have boundaries, correct? Can I walk up to you on the street and grab your ass? Hopefully the answer to that is no. Okay? You do have boundaries. So now we know you have boundaries. Now you know that you are able to set boundaries. Now, what are some other things that you are struggling with to set boundaries? Put those in the don't touch my ass boundary box and enforce it the same way. Got it? Next.
That's always a hard one.
Yep.
But once you master it, woo!
Yes.
Life gets pretty good. Britt, I feel like I need to set boundaries with my grandma. She thinks I care too much about my dog.
Okay, well, tell grandma that you need to set boundaries with her. Have a conversation with grandma, but be nice to grandma.
Over please. Tea and cookies.
Yes.
Of course. Kyle, if you're debating any venues in the Northeast England and need a rep to go for you to arrange anything, I'd be happy to do that if needed.
Okay, go ahead. I'm not debating anything in England now because I don't know of anything in England.
Teresa, I read almost daily, at least 5 days a week. At least 3 of those days start with positive quotes and or good news articles. Tomorrow's OSU Spay Neuter Day for the shelter I volunteer for, which means Library Day.
Awesome. Next.
Judy, thanks for Fargo. Safe travels.
Judy, we love you.
Proud of you.
You did great, Judy.
You did good.
Okay. Tell Marshall we love him too. Next.
Dad. Just want to say thanks for your advice and the vids. They help a lot. Do you have a brand of e-collar you'd suggest?
Yes, the same ones you see in all of our videos, and we have them on our website. It's the e-collar, the mini educator. You do not have to buy them from us. You can usually save a little bit of money on Amazon. So e-collar technologies, mini educator 300 is usually what most dogs need. Next.
Romeo finds a wife. Big fan, dude. I'm ex-military and have been working with canines for years. I now train psychiatric dogs nonprofit. Any tips on how to start doing seminars? I'd like to spread the word to my community.
So, I mean, they're hard to do. I would start with a 3-hour seminar, half day seminar. Not to try to get you to hire me, but I actually give it. I can help you with that because that's. I mean, I'm probably the right now the largest pet dog seminar in the United States. And that's not an ego statement. It's just fact. I don't think anybody's doing 25 seminars a year in the pet dog industry. If they are, congratulations on my love. I love all my other seminar people. Seminars are fantastic. It's a great way for people to learn. What I would do is just do it. Find a venue and do it. But how are you at helping people? How are you speaking? Practice. So videotape yourself and practice. Start out small. Maybe start out with a group class. Start out with a class in the park. Start with something simple. Something simple. So in order to engage people and get people motivated and then keep people's attention for us, we do a 2-day seminar. I also do a 7-day seminar. That's hard work. It's exhausting work, actually. Next.
Sheila, Jeff, my previous comment said I've used a bonker. It's not working to stop the barking.
You're probably using it improper, but go to a remote collar then.
She can't. She doesn't have a budget.
You're not using it properly then. So the bonker is this, no, and then bonk and you bonk hard. Next.
Bronwyn, it's always so lovely to catch a live. I always learn so much and feel so confident after watching you. Thank you so much, Jeff and Joelle. Have an awesome week.
Awesome. The way you feel after you're watching a live, I want you to start learning how to do that on your own. I want you to be able to learn how to self-motivate. Got it? Learn how to self-motivate, Bronwyn. Got it? I'm here for you. I'm here for you. Don't get me wrong.
Me too.
Okay. So is Joelle. Next.
Alicia, I appreciate everything you guys have to offer. Thank you so much. I'm saving this replay.
Awesome. Thanks, Alicia.
Sid, hi, J&J. Can't agree with you more. All the negative drives me to do more training with my GSC, my horse, and my clients, and be pleased with my accomplishments and that of the animals.
Exactly.
Bingo.
And good job for the hard work. Next.
Kyle. I'll get on it. So you need a place that doesn't give a fuck about negative people and will take any sort of backlash. Hard to come by in England, but not impossible.
No, it's not impossible. And this is the thing, what you'll do is this. You find a private spot. We don't have to give out the address. We can give out the location. We don't have to give out your, it's not your zip code. We don't have to give out the code at the end. We give a general area and we will instruct people a general area where it is, and at the last minute after you buy a ticket we will tell people exactly where it is. That's how we do an England seminar. Next.
Sheila, oh yes I am. She sees me anywhere near it, she gets timid.
Which one's Sheila?
The one, the dog that won't stop barking if she bonks.
Okay, well then you have to, okay, so what I need you to do is it's still gotta, you still have to follow through with it. No bonk. So your barking warrants a negative consequence. Next.
Kyle, I feel cheeky asking, but what's the incentive for the venue if I'm to ask?
So Kyle, there is no incentive except for, well, if it's a dog training center, they get business. If it's just a open venue, we might have to pay a fee. But most people host me and they make no money at all, but they get business from it. So they get future business. I come in for 2 days. But if it's a private facility, such as if a buddy of yours has a warehouse and has a back area or an area, and he's like, what's in it for me? Well, we'll talk a little bit of money, but not a lot. You know, so, but that's what it is. But I have paid rent for facilities, but usually it's like business. They get business from it. Next.
Jamie, I finally ordered the micro educator for my tiny 5-pound dog. Hope and pray it fits her.
Yeah, we'll make it fit. Next. You can also go behind the back, the dog's head. Okay, last couple questions because it's time for us to go.
I think this will be a good one to end it on. Paul. Hi, J&J from the UK. Best Q&A yet. Uplifting, informative, and honest. This is my positive podcast for the day. I will look out, too, for venues. Last one here was a blast.
Awesome. Paul, thank you so much. Guys, we are going to go. So we've got still... We can do laundry?
We can do laundry. We've got a lot of work to do.
Laundry, we have work to do. You feeling a little bit better?
Not really.
Okay, so then you should just rest. We still have a lot of social media to do. I've got to upload all the photos, get the photo album done. We have to do laundry. We've got to pack. And we've got to actually, we have to leave here at 4 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
Leave at 4 a.m. So.
I think they'll be up at like 2.
I'll be up at 3. Yeah, I don't need as much time as you. So, all right, guys. Madly in love with you. And for all the folks wanting to see us in Charlotte, we'll be in Charlotte, North Carolina this weekend. JeffGellmanSeminars.com. And, that's it. That's what we got. Love you all. Care about you tremendously. Honored and blessed. And remember, guys, be nice. Mm-hmm. Take care. Bye-bye.
Good night.